Welcome to the Matrix with your boy, Crime Stop. Let's get it.
EA Sports. It's in the game.
What's up, everybody, and thanks for dropping in for the third segment of The Vault in the Matrix with your boy Prime. I'm glad y'all could join me. If you haven't watched the first two, everything is in the description box below. And you see that little circle up at the top in the right hand corner. You'll also see the little car go across the screen where you can watch the first two. But I'm going to bring y'all the third installment of this and get right into it. So as y'all seeing right now, y'all seeing NBA Live 08. And this was the start of the actual levels. And this is where, you know, where this has actually, you know, came into play, where everything had transpired at that time, where everything was, you know, where they was making that transition to improve the game of NBA Live, where they wanted to go back and start with the fundamentals of the game. Now, this is going to be a long video because this is where they really emphasize on making games deep. This is where they emphasize a couple things in the game where they was doing real good by moving forward. Now, a lot of individuals at the time didn't play NBA Live 09 because a lot of the gaming community was on that transition of going towards the competition. And because of NBA Live 07 and how bad it was, they was losing traction. And a lot of people didn't see the actual improvements that was being done to NBA Live, you know, with this game. And as you see, Gilbert Arenas is coming into the arena. And as you see, they went to the actual real basketball gyms where you could actually practice. And you will see a lot of things that changed with movement, ball intangibility. And there were a lot of things in this game that were actually, you know, brought forth to the table, which I really love. I played the heck out of NBA Live 09. So I'm going to go ahead and break a lot of stuff down. So let's go ahead and get into it. So the first thing I want to let everybody see is some of the things that was, you know, brought forth, such as, some of the improvements that they actually brought. You will see, you know, the online, the team play, the versus. These were things that was brought forth to tip. As you see, the quick feature, which was the quick play. Now, you can get into a quick play match with some individuals and play a quick game with them online. There were a lot of online features in this game that I really, really love. Also, the EA Locker. This is something that they need to emphasize and bring back as well, where you can customize your actual avatar. And you will go to the actual EA website and check your stats, check the individuals that you encounter and come across. Now, you know, with the servers being down, and that's in all of the lives at the moment, you know, they were more online based like this one. You know, you can't get into the servers. And that was the main thing that was that's sad, that the servers are down and you can't do some of these modes that you would like to do. But anyway, as you see the new features, you got the quick play, and you have you know, these particular type of, you know, modes that you can actually do. And the team play. The team play was emphasized, where you can get a team of 5-on-5 and you can play against people online. The ESPN was fully integrated, as you see. You got ESPN on demand, where you can actually watch ESPN news on the game. You can literally watch ESPN news on the game, and they will just show you highlights and everything that was going on at SportsCenter. You also had your ESPN settings, where you see on the bottom, you'll have the ticker like they did in Live 07. You will actually have scores and, you know, little transactions and things that went on during the season. It will go across the bottom of the screen for you. And, you know, things of that magnitude. You also see, you see All-Star Weekend, you see your Dynasty Mode. This is where FIBA was introduced. It was introduced in NBA Live 08, where they introduced it fully. You see the scenario play, where you can make scenarios and customize certain situations in the game. So a lot of things was actually introduced in Live 08. So as y'all see, I'm just, you know, I'm going to show y'all some other things as well, and that I want to, you know, bring forward. Let's go ahead and get into the you know, the actual, you know, let me go ahead and get into it. Yes, the settings. So with the settings, it was the same setting format that was introduced in Live 07. And then also see here is that the control mechanics. Now, the control mechanics was, they actually made these better because now you have the quick strike. And this is where the quick strike was introduced with the new dribbling mechanics and where the ball was a little bit more tangible with the quick strike. And this is where they actually introduced that. You also see, you know, the protect ball button. Also on defense, now you have a defensive assist. The good thing about the defensive assist, now with your matchups, depending on what guy was matched up on who, you pressed and held down that L trigger, and it will make the guy that you're guarding, you'll go right to the guy that you're supposed to be guarding. If you want to play defense, you have to let it go, and then you have to play man defense up. That defense assist is something that needs to make a return in NBA Live. It was a very excellent function to use. Excellent function. And as you see the settings here, and again, like I said, it was things that were introduced, and you know that they introduced in NBA Live 07, and then they brought it over to NBA Live 08, and they increased it. Now, some of the AI tangibles in here you had to increase, but there were two things that was in here that was very effective: help defense effectiveness and physical play. That was something that you can adjust with the computer. Help side defense and physical play. Those are two things that you can actually adjust with the computer to make the computer smarter and emphasize the game to make it play better. And as we go down the list as well, you're going to see this new feature as well that was integrated into the game, where you can literally edit your players. Editing players, you can edit the players. And then the way that the rating system in this NBA Live, since it was the first time it was shown in NBA Live 07, they made it better in NBA Live 08. Now you can actually, you know, edit any category by, as you can see, you can edit all players, or you can go by single player and edit whatever, you know, category of rating that you wanted to, you know, alter. And you could do that. And that was something that was really, really good. And the one thing that was very good about NBA Live 08 was the introduction of go-to moves. The go-to moves was something that was signature in NBA Live 08 that they wanted to bring forth to the franchise. And that was something lovely. This is when they really integrated signature moves, and they brought the signature into the game. And as you see it on KG, Kevin Garnett, and as you see, and that's his signature go-to move. And they put signature shots in here. Now, Live did have signature shots to an extent. Now we're looking at Paul Pierce. But they had signature moves in the game, but it wasn't a lot of it. It really wasn't fluid. And this is why I say, again, the levels was introduced in NBA Live because of this game. Because they went back to the fundamentals. And I'm also going to have a video where y'all can actually see that, where they broke that down. And I will have that in the description box, and it'll be in that card at the top, and y'all can gladly see that. And y'all can actually see that video where they actually transitioned from Live 07 to Live 08 and where they broke it down, so y'all will actually know. And this is where Live's transition actually started before the debacle. And as you see, and you're looking at Paul Pierce. Next, you got Ray Allen. And you have Ray Allen. And, you know, and I'm showing everybody's go-to move as we go along, so you will see it as we go. And, you know, as we're talking about this. And also, they had hotspots. This is where the hotspots was introduced as well. And this was something that was a good feature at the time. But when you go back at it and when you look at it, if you really, really go back into it, and as you see the hotspots, you see Ray Allen's moderate, his cold spots, and his hotspots. You know, it was good. It was a very, very good idea because it emphasized on percentage on where individuals liked the ball and where they, you know, shot better from the ball from their percentage. And as we see LeBron James, LB Jizzle, and that was a good thing with the hot spots. So You know, but it was kind of cheese because people would just go to those red spots and just know where they was and bring it up and just shoot from there, you know, to the pose of when we get further on down in the vault, when I bring forth the other titles, you know, you'll see a little bit more how they improved on that. But this was the first adaptation of the hotspots, and, you know, when they brought it forth to the table. And like I say, it was a very good feature that they brought forward. So, you know, but it was always ways to improve it. But just to introduce certain things was a very good thing, you know, that they did. So as you see in LeBron James, and you seeing, like I say again, the signature and the significance of this, I just want to show everybody's hotspots and what it was and where signature was integrated into the game. You know, the sad part about it is, like I say, with NBA Live is that, and this is Dirk Nowitzki, where he has his kickback. You actually see this. You know, the thing about NBA Live that saddens me the most is that a lot of individuals really didn't play NBA Live 08, you know, and some of the other titles. And they really didn't get a chance to really experience and understand what they were trying. Look at Dirk's hot spots. Oh, my God. He got a lot of red. But you have to really look at, you know, everything that was brought forth to the table. You know, what they was trying to do. They was trying to go sim. And when they was trying to go sim, there's a lot of things that, you know, that they're just trying to, you know, go with. And, you know, the question out of this was that, you know, I really don't know what actually happened. There was a lot of great producers, there was a lot of great devs that they had, and the things that they was moving for, and at that time it was something that was extremely, extremely good. And as you see right now, you're seeing AI Allen Iverson, the answer, you know, and you're seeing his go-to move, his little throw-up shot. And you know, like I said again, there was a lot of good things that they incorporated in the game. All they had to do was just build on it, you know. You know, and this was really the, besides this, you know, there was only one other title that incorporated the go-to moves, which was kind of sad, but, you know, they took it away. And this was something that a lot of individuals really wanted to keep because, you know, it had signature. And at the same time, AI's hot and cold spots as well. He got more moderate than anything. And there we go. Carmelo. Melo. And now, you know, I really would like to hear people's thoughts and takes on, you know, after you watch this. Again, people, this is going to be a long video because I want to showcase everyone a lot of things that a lot of people didn't get a chance to really look at in NBA Live 08. Y'all didn't get a chance to really look at all this. There are certain things that NBA Live 08 individuals don't remember, they can't recall, and, you know, or the ones that just haven't played it at all. Here go Melo's hot and cold spots and his moderate spots. So, you know, it's good to bring this forth to the actual community and, you know, the young individuals that are really, really coming up. And as you see, and a lot of go-to moves, they, you know, you have to really, really look at the detail. And as you see, Chauncey Billups, big shot, Chauncey. This is where we get into everything else. So, I mean, you really have to really look at that, people, and, you know, take that, you know, into consideration, where the youth, look at this hot and cold zones, where you have to take that into consideration. You know, and now when it came down to like animations and, you know, certain, you know, basketball movements, they really emphasized, they really put this at NBA Live 08. They really did. Because NBA Live 07 was so bad that, you know, they wanted to take it upon themselves to go ahead and get basketball movement. They wanted to take it upon themselves to bring back, you know, that grace that NBA Live once had. And they were starting it off with NBA Live 08. And I wasn't disappointed. Also with the free throw, you know, when we get a little bit further into the video, I'll explain that a little bit more. So now we're going to get to Rasheed Wallace. And they have his go-to move, that high, you know, fade, which is absolutely beautiful. And again, people are so stuck on, you know, 2K because they played it for so long. And at that, and it's a good, I wish that people would have actually played NBA Live 08. I can't stress that. Look at this Hot and Cold Zones. And she could just shoot. But I can't say that enough, that I wish people would have played NBA Live 08. And, you know, they would have played it and, you know, really, really took the time and really did their homework on it. Because, you know, NBA Live 08 was a very, very fun game, but it had a lot of, you know, great things in the game as well. B. Diddy, Baron Davis, we're going to get with the Diddy. And you see his go-to move, the little step back, the little hesitation. So, you know, I mean, people, you know, and like I say, this game was fun, and when they put the go-to moves in there, as you see, it's Hot and Cold Zones as well. And who is this guy right here? It's T-Mac. Y'all don't know about Mac. Y'all missing out on T-Mac. And y'all seeing T-Mac's go-to move. And, oh, and you know what, people? What I forgot to mention, the soundtrack in NBA Live 08 is absolutely phenomenal. The music, the soundtrack is absolutely phenomenal. I mean, it is absolutely phenomenal. But back to the point of it, as you see Tracy McGrady, and I hope y'all actually seeing some of the actual signature jump shots, some of the signature moves. Now, when it came down to the quick strike, so let me go ahead and break down the quick strike while I'm looking at this. You're going to see some signature layups. You're also going to see some things that are in the game that you actually like, that's distinguishable, and that they actually, you know, pinpoint on and went through. And you're looking at Yabow, Yummy. And you can distinguish the difference between a big guy's dribbling and a guard, and a guy that really, really had handles. They really broke that down and made it distinguishable, and they brought it forth in the NBA Live 08. And this is when they first started it. But big guys can't dribble. They can't go through their legs. They really can't ball handle all like that. So you, it's really distinguishable and it's presentable. And you can actually see it and distinguish, you know, between the two. You can really, really see the difference. And it's displayed in the game. Now you got Jermaine O'Neal, Indiana Pacers. A lot of cats don't remember about Jermaine. He was a beast. He came out of high school. He was drafted by the Portland Trail Blazers, and he became a star in his own right when he went to Indiana. But if it wasn't for injuries and, you know, all that with his knees, Jermaine O'Neal was a beast, people. You got to understand. He was an animal. So, what I could tell y'all is that with the quick strike, it was fluid. It really worked, and that was a good thing. And they named it the quick strike because they wanted to, you know, introduce these new dribbling mechanics to incorporate with the freestyle. The freestyle is with your right thumbstick. The quick strike is the method. So, you know, the quick strike is the good thing where, you know, left, right, going through the legs, doing everything with the right thumbstick and quickly. To the pose of everybody, where the hands, and you would see the tangibles, you know, where the ball actually got into the hand, where it wasn't, you know, some, you know, and, you know, where they emphasize more with the, you know, between big men and small. Now you're seeing Elden Brand. This is prime. In his prime, Elden Brand, before he had all the injuries to his back and to his knees. He was a star when he was with the Clippers. A lot of people, y'all forget, when Elden Brand got drafted, Elden Brand was a monster. I mean, Elden Brand wasn't no slouch, people. Elden Brand was no joke. Elden Brand was a beast. So, you know, a lot of people, they don't know who Elden Brand was, but as y'all seen his go-to move as well. And you can distinguish, like I said, you can tell the difference between individuals that's in the post. Now, in this game, okay, with the go-to moves, they do, they have signature in this game. Now you're looking at Kobe the Mamba, Kobe Bryant. You're looking at the Mamba, and they do have his fadeaway in here. And that's the thing that's going to bother a lot of people when y'all looking at these go-to moves, is like, why did they take these out? Why didn't they build off of this? The ideas were great. The ideas were very, very sound. But it's, you know, like I always say, and as y'all see, it's hot spots and cold spots. And Kobe hot everywhere. But, I mean, when you look at this, it's going to bring out a lot of memories, and then it's going to make you scratch your head, because there's a lot of things that was incorporated. Now, when they did this, you know, a lot of people going to think, well, you know, the competition did this first. No, everything that the competition does, Live has did it first. Now you're looking at Pau Gasol, my man, Pau. So you're looking at Pau, and y'all get to see him as well. But that's the things that I like to, you know, bring forth with this is that I really want everybody to really understand and, you know, look and, you know, it's so much things that I want to say is that, you know, why did they take this? And like I say, NBA Live 08 was that stepping stone where they integrated a lot of stuff into the game. Now you're looking at D-Wade Flash. Wade. And you will see his actual go-to move as well that he does in real life. And, you know, and like I say again, y'all can actually see some signature. Like I say, y'all will see some things that, this is the thing I want to say too. The layups and everything that's actually in this title and titles moving forward, you are going to see things that are like, it's going to make you scratch your head. Like, why did they go away from this? Why didn't they just, you know, make it better and, you know, build off of it, you know? And this is things that are baffling to this day that a lot of people still to this day, we don't understand. It could be some of the creators, because a lot of the creators that made this are not at EA anymore. Now you got the big old whale, the Diesel, the Shaq, and you will see his go-to move as well. You know, he had that teardrop in the lane, and they did a good job on it. When y'all go back and watch that video, like I said, it's in the card annotation up at the top in the right-hand corner. You can click on it or just click on the link of the playlist. It's going to be in the description box below or the annotations at the end of the video. And y'all can actually go ahead and go into the vault. I mean, y'all will go to that video and you will literally see what they done. The trajectory of the ball was altered, because in Live 07, the ball used to go like an arc. It used to go real, real high. So they went ahead and they did new things to make the trajectory of the ball look better when you release it. And here you go as Michael Redd. You know, a very, very good shooting guard. If injuries didn't plague him, he would have been up there too, but he was a shooter. Michael Redd was a very, very good, shooter coming off those screens, and he did his thing, man. Michael Redd was an animal. But again, a lot of these individuals, a lot of these, you know, youngsters out here, they're not going to even remember these players, because again, like I said in my, one video that I said was that, you know, a lot of these individuals were either babies or they were just born or they just didn't get into the game of basketball just yet. But Michael Redd was a very, very good two guard. He was a shooter. And here we go with Vince Carter, Vincenity. So, you know, and that's why I say I'm showing everyone everything. I'm not trying to leave nothing out, because I want to showcase these things in the right light for the individuals that's out there, because again, they didn't get a chance to play the game, or they didn't want to play the game. And that's kind of, you know, that's kind of sad that they didn't. And again, without the servers being up, people, look at Vince Carter and his hotspots, with the servers being down, you're not going to get the full effect of these games. Here we go with Chris Paul. Now, Chris Paul is the only player in this game that had two go-to moves. He had two, but they emphasized on one, which is his floater. But he had two go-to moves. You see the step-back jump shot, and then you see his floater. He had two. So, Chris Paul was a rare player in the game that had two signature go-to moves in the game. which is kind of crazy because, you know, man, he was cheese. A lot of people would use the Hornets and NBA Live 08, and they would do all type of stuff with Chris Paul because he had two of them. So, but you can't get mad at it because that's what the man does. Chris Paul, he a beast. So, you know, and I hope y'all looking at the sequences and some of the animation and some of the movement that was there. The signature was there. Now we got Nash, Nash, Steve Nash, Nash, Nash. But, his go-to move, I just see his hot spots. Y'all see his go-to move as well. His go-to move is in the paint, and y'all should know I'm going to show it to you, everyone. It's really in the paint. There it goes. I activated it because it was in the paint, but then y'all see there it go. You'll see a little bit more, and you know as I get it out, that's his go-to move in the paint. That's we got Sean Marion, the Matrix, in his prime. He was an animal. And, you know, I want, and this is so enjoyable because, you know, it brings back so many memories. I wish that the servers were up at this present moment. And, you know, to be honest with you, I would be going ham right about now. I would be on the sticks playing this game. It wouldn't even be no question because I would be on it, getting it in, doing what I do. And I mean, I can't stress it enough. And as you see, they do have his jump shot in here. And again, people, like I said, this is where they was getting the transition of getting signature into the game. And NBA Live 08 displayed it extremely well. There you go, as you see his hot and cold spots and, you know, what they're trying to do. Now we're going to Sacramento, run our test. And, so as we're getting forward and I'm closing this down with that, you know, NBA Live 08, like I said, incorporated so many things. And, you know, they need to, we're nowhere in a new age of, you know, of the game. But when you remember what I always stress about and what I always say is that you have to go back to your history to look at certain things that you did good and what you did right. And there's nothing wrong about going back to those principles, you know, and trying to incorporate that. Timmy Duncan. Now, y'all going to see something in here that now with Tim Duncan, he does hit his shot off the glass. Y'all are going to see that when he does his signature move. He hits his shot off the glass. That is his signature move. When y'all see it, y'all going to be like, wow, because they have his signature shot in the game. You see his go-to move. This is what impressed me the most because they have his signature move when he's in the block. They got his signature jump shot. They got Tim Duncan to a T. I mean, they put Timmy to a T. That's why I say I'm not even mad at that. I mean, they did an excellent job on Tim Duncan. Look at his hot and cold zones, what he does. He getting that post. It's a wrap. You do his little go-to move, it's a wrap. And you can still do that pro hop and that spin in the post. Again, remember what I said at the beginning about the control mechanics. The control mechanics haven't changed. You know, and I'll let that go further down where it did change and y'all will see what has changed and what has transpired. And we got Tony Parker. And you see the flash, you see how quick he dribbles because he has fast dribbles. And as you see his floater, he does have his floater, his signature move, which is that floater. Once he get in that paint, and a lot of cats would do that too with Tony Parker. They'll do his floater all the dang time. It was cheese, but they'll always do his floater once he got in the paint. But his layup is so high, it's crazy. It's ridiculous. His layup is off the chain. But what I was about to say is that, you know, the signatures is... And Ginobili, y'all can't help it. His name is Nobly. You see his go-to move as well. And You know, and again, people, you are actually seeing, like I said, they did a good job with it with the first start of it. And it's so amazing that they went away from this. This is the thing. And this is things that were, like I said, again, that was incorporated. I cannot say that enough. I know I'm repeating myself. I know I'm being repetitive and everything, people. But, you know, it's so baffling that, you know, what you're saying on the screen for yourself is that you looking at it now for yourself. And again, like I say, a lot of people forgot, or a lot of people just didn't play the game. So, you know, so now we're going to go ahead and we're going to get to Chris Bosh, you know, when he was in Toronto. Now, his go-to move is a little bit generic. I don't know. They could have really, really worked on his a little bit better. But at the same time, he's left-handed, you know, as you see it right there. You know, his go-to move. And, you know, Chris Bosh was a shooter, like I said. But, you know, like I said, the things that they did, there go right there, his go-to move. And, you know, they have a lot of individuals. They have a lot of, you know, players' moves that almost that are similar to one another if you really, really look at it. But if you really, really look real closely, you break it down, you can see the difference with it. And that's why I said, as time would have went on, they could have smoothed a lot of stuff out. And this is just EA's models on how they done stuff for years. There's nothing that's really been, you know, different. That's just the way that they do things. So there's nothing wrong with it. That's why it's called, you know, certain things that's different. And a lot of individuals are not just used to that, and they're not incorporated with it. High spot, jump shot, splash. Now we're going to the Utah Jazz. We got big Deron Williams. And a lot of people, y'all forget Deron Williams was a beast. He was considered the best point guard in the NBA at the time when he was in Utah. And to me, he was the best point guard in the NBA. Just because of his size, his skill, what he can do as everything. And the system that he was in when he was in Utah. As y'all see his hot and cold zones. Look, he only got one cold zone. Deron Williams wasn't no joke. D. Will was a beast. And a lot of individuals, y'all need to know that. He got his goal. And they got his go-to move to a T. Because he got that step-back jumper. That's what he does. You know, that's what D. Will does. That step-back jumper. And we got Carlos Boozer. You know, and at the time, like, you know, Carlos Boozer was an all-star, people. He was very, very good. Him and Deron Williams had a very, very good, you know, 1-2 punch. They had some great, great personnel in Utah alongside with AK-47, which is Andre Kirilenko. You had Amet Okor. Utah had a very nice team, you know, but it all got dismantled. As y'all see, it's hot and cold zones, you know, but, you know, at that time. But what we're going to do, and, you know, as I say, as we get a little bit further down and, you know, get it going, you know, and we're getting close to the end of the hot and cold of the, and it got big old Agent Zero, Abachi, give it a read us, the cover athlete of the game, as y'all saw at the beginning, and y'all see his go-to move as well, his step back, you know, which is his signature, so, and, you know, you know, his stuff is all red, so he can just shoot the lights out, give it to Arenas, you know. But if it weren't for injuries for him and, you know, the things that he did, give it to Arenas, the sky's the limit was for him. But give it to Arenas was a monster. A lot of individuals forgetting about Agent Zero. So, and then we got Anton Jameson. Ton! And his go-to move is a little flip shot. You know, a lot of people would use the Wizard. They'll use that all the time. Just like it was with Sean Marion and stuff. You know, they'll do that flip shot. They'll always do it all the time. You know, and that was the thing about the go-to moves, too. As you see, it's hot and cold zones. You know, they would use a lot of the go-to moves as cheese. But you could defend it. Sometimes, you know, you couldn't. It depends on the player, but it depends on what it was. And again, like I said, some of them may look a little bit similar. Some of them may not. You know, it depends on how good your eye is. Me, personally, a lot, I say 95% of them are different. They're not all the same. They may look that way because of the motion, but they're all different if you really, really pay attention to them. So what we're going to do right now, I'm going to go ahead and get everybody into some actual NBA Live 08 gameplay. And I want y'all to really, really look at the game, you know, at the time. And I want y'all to really, really look at it. And I want y'all to break it down. So as I'm moving this over, now we're going to go ahead and I'm going to use the Denver Nuggets and the Detroit Pistons. That's who I'm going to let play, and then everybody can go from there and go from there. Oh, and another thing that was sweet, they had trivia questions and games where you can get points and stuff while the game was loading. As you see, the trivia game, and it was Jordan questions powered by ESPN. You will see that stuff, and then you can get an achievement for it. But then you will actually see your scores on the ESPN site. That was a good thing with the trivia questions. They had trivia questions during the low screen. This is fire. This is something they need to return to do so it can help individuals with their basketball so they will know certain things. So we're going to get into this little game, play or whatever, so everybody can see for themselves and get into it. And as you see, like I say, with the announcer, has always been the same announcer. They tweet them as years went on, but it's the same announcer. But remember what I said before in early installments of NBA Live, and when I go ahead and go to the other gen consoles, you know, and I start putting them up in the vault for everyone, because that's what I'm going to do. I'm going to do get them all for everyone. They showed the actual introduction, and they broke it down, and they emphasized stuff on presentation, as you see. The presentation was really good. They showed the starting lineup. They went up and down through every player. And that's why I say when it comes down to games, it's like, to me, it seems like they get lazy and they water stuff down. And there's no part of them doing that. But when it came down to, you know, these three titles, as y'all, if y'all went to and saw them all, this was part of this is when they got the introduction where it was really, really good. And, you know, when they did the starting lineup, it was really, really good. And they did an excellent job with it. That's just to me. It might not do good for everybody else because everybody's so used to everything else. But you have to look at everything, how it had progressed, you know, from that time. From, you know, you can, I'm just talking about for the next gen consoles, meaning when it got on the 360 and the PlayStation 3. Now, this was the first, the first NBA Live on the next gen consoles that was on the PlayStation 3. NBA Live, was, you know, all the other titles, they wasn't really on the other on some of the other consoles. NBA Live 08 was on this, you know, on this Xbox One, PS, and, you know, PC, PlayStation 2, PlayStation, you know, oh no, it wasn't on PlayStation 2. I'm sorry, it was just PlayStation 3, 360, you know, PC. So they transitioned it, and when you look at some of the animations in here and the way that it plays, y'all will actually see they call fouls, you know, say on the regular, and you will see some of the animations where they actually walk up, which is real live actual basketball movement. As you see, Rasheed Wallace, true basketball free throw routine. They had basketball signature in this game. They had the shots. They had everything down packed, and they went away from it. Why? Why? And, you know, this is the thing that everybody was addressing for, and they put it in the game, but they took it out. You know, when you look at some of that, as you're looking at Allen Iverson, the way he walks it up, you will see them protect the ball. You will see that Chauncey Billups is in a defensive stance, and he stays on his man. And the way, as he comes up to it, you see how he backed up. That's called anticipation. Now, the artificial intelligence was smart on some things, but the artificial intelligence was not too bright in a lot of other things, where you would see some of the things that was actually in the game when you let the computer play the computer. And, you know, sometimes it wouldn't drive when it's supposed to, you know, and it's on Superstar. So the AI, NBA Live 08 was really an easy game when you played the computer, because the computer really wasn't a challenge in this game. However, you can see some of the things that they could have emphasized more by increasing the, you know, increasing the, how can I say it? Increasing, you know, the artificial intelligence of the game, you know, with the computer. So, you know, it was just a lot of things with the computer that was not really, really good at all. But when it come down to the gameplay of NBA Live 08, I really, really loved it. I mean, I loved the gameplay in NBA Live 08 because I played it so much, you know, because the quick strike was so fluid. They fixed the rebounding. You know, movement was very crisp. A lot of individuals didn't like NBA Live 08's movement. The ones that did play are the ones that were saying it wasn't. That's because, you know, they just didn't know how to really, really play the game or get used to it. That's what I'm saying. You know, that's what I say. Well, it's to each his own. Everybody has their own outlook and their perspective on certain things and how they, you know, how they look at stuff. Wow, and as you see, oh, nice steal. Good layup. And Detroit is up right about now. Denver getting hurt right about now. They getting hurt. But yeah, you know, I wanted to get the gameplay going for everybody as well. And like I said, it was going to be a long video, but NBA Live 08 had so much stuff that I wanted to show, to showcase, and get everyone through because, like I said, you know, I want everybody to see. Good one. So, Richard Hamilton got fouled. I think he's going to the line, if I'm not mistaken. Yeah, he is. See? Signature free throw. Y'all see that? That's Richard Hamilton, signature free throw. And they took it out the game. They took signature free throws out the game. Why? I don't know. But, you know, I'm talking about just with other players. They don't have it for everybody. But in this, they had it for a lot of players. And it looks like they only focus on the stars. But in this, they had it for a lot of players. They just didn't have it for stars. They had it for a lot of other players. They had their signature. They had their signature free throws. Just like with the signature go-to moves. You know, and they didn't really emphasize, other things until further titles. And remember what we always say. They incorporate things and then they take it out and put something else in. Why don't you just keep that and move forward with it? That's the thing that is so baffling, which it does not make any sense, us as a consumer, as a whole. It doesn't make any sense. To this day, it doesn't make any sense. But anyway, I hope y'all enjoying the gameplay, and as everything did, and Allen Iverson going for the jump shot, good two by AI. Now, hopefully Denver goes on a little run. As you see, Chauncey Billups bringing the ball up. And as you see the way the motions look very, very good on the dribbling mechanics. You know, hiding the ball, shielding the ball, keeping the ball shielded. Good rebound mechanic. Two hands, jump up with two hands to go get it. Nice transition to Melo. Denver trying to make a run. Yeah, because they see they was getting their butt whooped. Like I said, the AI is like funny in this game to an extent because, you know, but at the same time, you know, and as you look at Chauncey Billups, he's protecting the ball. They protect the ball. They shield the ball with the back. That's what I'm saying. They took all these tangibles out the game. Nice drive by Tayshaun. He went for the strip. You reach, I teach. So, nice take by Tayshaun. You know, so these are things that were, you know, that you see. And like I said again, the levels were there. This was the first thing with the levels. And when I meant by the levels, this is what I meant by when it NBA Live 08. Because they went back to the fundamentals of basketball, and you see a lot of it in this game. There's tons of it in it. So, you know, movement, you know, passing, dribbling, you know, body movement, what they emphasized on. And that was the key to me. When it came down to the game, that was a very, very big key. That was something that was a very, very huge thing that they had to do and that they did, and then moving forward. You know, they call fouls in here. You know, you get body. You know, you just ain't just gonna go in the lane and everything like that in here like that. You get body. You know, bodies is respected. You will see how AI is not moving him because he's little. He's just moving him back. He's just getting hit back. Those are the things that I talk about. Those are the tangibles I'm talking about. Oh, nice shot. So, you know, Diagu, you know, and, you know, those are things that were, you know, put into these titles. He's going, who's that, Flip Murray? Yes. So that's the end of this. So what we're going to do, we're going to go ahead and go to the next and last spot of the video. And I just want to break this down. I hope y'all enjoyed that little bit of gameplay. I want y'all to break it down and tell me what y'all saw, what y'all see from that. So we're going to go ahead and go through the roster so y'all can see the rosters for yourself. We're going to start with the Hawks. We got Josh Smith, Joe Johnson, Speedy Claxton, Josh Childress, Tyronn Lue-Johnson. Then you got the Celtics with Garnett, Paul Pierce, Ray Allen, Rajon Rondo, Tony Allen, Brian Scalabrine, Leon Poe. You got the Charlotte Bobcats, Jason Richardson, Felton. You got Adam Morrison, Jake Vosko. Then we're going to go over to the Chicago Bulls, Big Ben, Luol Deng, Ben Gordon, Kirk Heinrich. Joaquin Noah wasn't starting yet because Big Ben was there. Cavs, you got LBJ, Drew Gooden, Eric Snow, Shannon Brown. And this was the best format for the ratings to me because you see their signature on there. This was absolutely beautiful. And the way that it looks as y'all looking at it, that's absolutely beautiful. They should bring this back. This is probably the best rating presentation format that they had. This is the best. I mean, not only that it looked real good, it had the real pictures, it flowed real good, it had the initials and cursive. The way that the detail was, with this was absolutely great. And I loved it. Now we're in the Golden State Warriors, Big Al Harrington, Captain Jack, Monte Ellis, and B. Diddy. They had a squad. And you saw the other teams as well as I'm breaking it down. Azabuke, Delphine, Yao Ming, Chuck Hayes, T-Mac, Shane Battier, Stevie Franchise, Mike James, Bonzi, Luther Head, Bobby Shore, Skip to Malou, Indiana Pacers, as you see, Mike Dunleavy, Danny Granger, they had a squad too. These teams were they were good teams back in the day. I mean, it was like more balanced with the teams. The Clippers, when they was in their heyday, see, everybody thought the Clippers was just bad. The Clippers always had nice teams, man. They just never won all like that. I mean, they always had squads, but it's just that they would never win. Of course, my Lakers, you got L.O., Luke, Kobe, Derek Fisher. This is the year that we got Pau Gasol. So this is the year. And again, people, the trades, like the download rosters, you can't get those. So these are the ones that was with the game when you booted up, when it first was. But the rosters were different. As you see, the Memphis Grizzlies, they had a squad. Pau, Rudy Gay, Mike Conley, squad. And they had Kyle Lowry. This is when they first got Darko. Then Shaq. D-Wade on the Heat. So, a lot of these teams, they had squads. Zoe, of course, Milwaukee Bucks, they had a nice team at that time. You had Michael Redd. You had Earl Boykins, Bobby Simmons, So, a lot, like I said, these squads were nice. Minnesota, you had Al Jefferson, Ricky Davis, Randy Foy, Sebastian Telfair. These teams had squads, people. I mean, these were not no scrubby teams. These teams had squads. So, of course, the big three and with the Nets, with Kidd, Vince, and Richard Jefferson. And New Orleans had a squad. Look at these. Pager, Mo Pete, Chris Paul, Tyson Chandler, David West. Ooh. Whew. Them boys had a squad. Knicks didn't have a bad team neither. Z-Bo! Jamal Crawford, Starberry, who I didn't really like. I didn't like Stephon Marbury like that. Lil Nate, Jerome Jones, Malik Rose, Fred Jones, Dwight Howard, Rashard Lewis. This was the when they had got Rashard Lewis that year. They had Tito Turkoglu. This is on the transition of when Orlando was coming to power. At that time, Pat Garrity. Of course, the Sixers, they lost AI because he had got traded that following year. He had went to Denver. He had got traded. They still had Lou Williams. Phoenix, you had Stoudemire, Grant Hill, Rajon Bell, Steve Nash, Alonzo. You had Marion. They had a squad. Damn. Phoenix. And, of course, you had, Portland. They had a squad, too. And they had Brandon Roy. Just imagine if they would have had Lillard on this team and Brandon Roy was never hurt. And you still had Gray Oden, and they never, oh my God, Portland, Sacramento, this is when they still had a squad. This is back in, like I say, back in 08, like I say, Sacramento had a squad, they had a team, but everything just went downhill from there, with Ron Artest and Sharif Abdul-Rahim, Mike Bibby, Kevin Martin, Brad Miller, of course, the Spurs, you had the big three, and Timmy, Bruce Bowen, you had Michael Finley, Tony Parker, Ginobili, Big Shot Rob. So, yeah, they had their squad. Of course, in the Seattle Sonics, the Sonics were still still the team. And this was the last year before they had went to Oklahoma City. This was the last game that they was in Seattle. This is a good thing, too, because the Seattle Sonics is in those games. So the last three games, the Sonics are in the game. So that's why they are precious to a lot of people in all the other, in the older games. Of course, the Toronto Raptors, they had their nice little squad with a lot of people from overseas. Of course, like I said before, I stated Utah Jazz, they had a phenomenal team. They had a squad, man. Utah had a squad. Just imagine if Deron Williams and Boozer and all them didn't get the big head and start doing all that crazy stuff. Same thing with the Washington Wizards, with their big three. With Tyon and Karan, Gilbert Arenas, you see Nick Young, they had Etan Thomas, you know, they had Brandon Haywood, and of course you see the Eastern All-Stars, everybody that's on there. Yeah, they had a nice team, Eastern All-Stars. And then you had the West, and the West was better than the East. I mean, when you look at it, the West is better than the East. Gah! Way better than the East. And this is where you got the European teams, and then you got the rookies and the sophomores, and then Team Adidas. This is when Team Adidas was incorporated. This is the first time they incorporated Team Adidas. And, of course, you had the European teams with the FIBA teams, and when they incorporated that, so... you know, these were a lot of things, and y'all was moving forward, people. So I hope y'all enjoyed this. Please subscribe to the channel. I mean, actually do it like this. Subscribe to the channel. If you want more good content, please do so. Oh, and last but not least, before I go, again, like I said before, NBA Live 07 was the first game to incorporate the big stat rating system. It carried all the way over until NBA Live 09. And this is where they need to go back to of incorporating. And this is, like I said, you see the rating on the right where it shows the players in that grid. That's absolutely beautiful. And it actually was accurate and correct. This is what they need to bring back. When you actually look at it, look at the rating systems. Look how deep it is. The deepest rating system ever in a video game, and it was incorporated in NBA Live and up to date with the ESPN, with the live stats that you can actually do when you sign in. You can't do it because the servers are down. Well, people, this is your boy Prime. Thanks for dropping in for this segment of The Matrix, the third installment of The Vault. I'm glad y'all can join me. I hope y'all enjoying The Vault. Please put your comments down, subscribe to the channel, make sure you follow me on Twitter. Also, check out the other two videos, the other two episodes of this. It's going to be more coming into The Vault, as you see Kevin Durant. I did bring him out so everybody can see him. And y'all be blessed, everyone. I hope y'all enjoyed it, and just let me know how y'all feel and go from there. All right, y'all, this segment of The Vault is out.